Hello students, welcome to this series on personal selling. Today we are going to study the impact of motivation on salespeople. Now motivation is an important aspect of management and a basic concern for the organization. Motivation is a kind of impulse or a behavior which changes the attitude of the people. Motivation is the process of getting people to act willingly towards achieving greater satisfaction of their personal needs through the achievement of the company's goals and objective. Now, people have different needs, and when each need is genuinely satisfied, he basically feels motivated to get associated with the other need. The basic important needs related to person's life are the physiological needs, that is, people need food, health, and basic security, and this could be fulfilled by the money requirements. So the first issue related to motivating the employees is to pay a better salary. Then is the safety needs. This is the addressing of the need related to the physical and the emotional needs of the people in terms of the security and the health issues of the people. So the company has to build in a system where life of people is secured. Social need is the sense of belongingness to the company. This is like you feel accepted within a group and you feel a feeling of a kind of trustworthy relationship with people. This is a kind of need related to social affection and social acceptance. So the company has to build into teams and groups which feel related to each other. People have to be task oriented and people have to relate to their duties. Then is the need for esteem. Esteem is a kind of basic feeling associated with the self-respect and achievement. So it is the duty of the company to provide jobs which are challenging and which are genuinely related to the people's need so that they can crystallize their basic abilities to show their talents. Then is the self-actualization needs. This is the higher level of need where people relate to the needs of self-achievement in terms so as to self-fulfill their desires and passions to do something new in life. This is the innovation and the kind of the creativity associated with life. We have to genuinely build in the kinds of feelings associated with the each ladder of transformation of the people. The company has to relate to both the financial incentives and the non-financial incentives. The financial commitments relate to the protection of people's salary, even in recession, protection of people's wages in terms of times of needs, and it is the kind of the life security, the insurance, the assurance given by the company. The individuals basically have to influence their activities in such a way that they have the options to grow up with the company's basic goals and objectives. Now, basically, it is important that when people are gaining through their career objectives, they in the course of action gain through the company's objectives also. The employees must have that little independence so as to involve in the activities of decision making, which gives them a kind of a self-respect so as to show their performance. Now, basic aspects related to achievement in terms of the power and position in the company are motivating factors. According to McLachlan, there are three factors which motivate employees to take up their jobs in the companies. This relate to the achievement of the individual striving to perform higher, and then is the power, and then is the affiliation. Now, achievement is related when you excel in some field. If you get better results, better turnovers, and you look into the higher profile clients in terms of giving better businesses and profits to the company, most of the employees feel satisfied because this is the where the company has the scope in order so that the employees can grow up with that kind of landscape of business. Power is the kind of the desire to control the kind of activities which they are associated. It is the kind of the basic influencing power which genuinely relate to the activities which can impress and influence people in the field. Affiliation is the desire to build a kind of a close network and a kind of a system of harmonious relationships. So these are the basic aspects which the company has to look after the employees in such a way that we built a system where a kind of a rapport is created between the employees' needs, that is the salespeople's needs, and the company's needs. Now you come to the expectancy theory. See this model where we have shown you the individual's personal effort. The individual's personal effort is resulted into the individual's performance, and this results into the rewards from the company and the achievement against the kind of the personal goals of the people. Now when you build a relationship effort, you have this effort versus your performance, then the relationship performance versus the rewards you have, and the relationship rewards versus the goals you have. So the individual's perception with each aspect, that is with the performance, the effort will be different. With the rewards, the performance will be different, and with the extent to the goal achievement, it will be different. So the company has to realize the stages with which people are associated, and with each stage it has to give a kind of a different motivating aspects. There could be various causes of dissatisfaction which can put the sales of the company down and which could frustrate the employees. It is always said that the loyal and the committed employees are the biggest assets for the company, and if the employees are not satisfied, they basically carry this satisfaction to the customers. See, if I'm not happy, how can I make my customers happy? So the causes of the dissatisfaction have to be understood, and these are the basic causes of demotivation. First, let's see this model where we have shown you the causes of demotivation. We have the job uncertainties, the insecurity of tenure, the ill-defined roles and responsibilities, the poor training given to people, and the absence of the performance standards. This relates to the kind of the uncertainty which exists into the market. Then there could be job imbalances, that is the personal qualifications where you are not able to meet with the job requirements. It is the incorrect job assignment, the poor opportunities, and the poor job content variety. Then the inadequate management would relate to the limited management skills, the manager's prejudices, the poor management control, the inadequate communication, and the inadequate company personnel's development program. The inadequate working environments relate to poor equipment of the companies, poor locations, and poor work relation. The poor compensation relates to the uncompetitive income and the rewards and incentives given to the employees, the inequitable rewards and incentive programs, the absence of the merit reward programs, the uncompetitive fringe benefits, the feeling of being paid undervalued. Then you have the poor prospects. Poor prospects relates to the limited internal promotion systems, the limited opportunities to increase the knowledge and the skills related to the particular job. So these are the basic factors which can imbalance the feelings of the employees related to the company. You have to look after the employees in such a way that we relate to each aspect and give a positive environment which builds a trustful relationship with the employees. If employees are happy, half of the job of the company is done. How we look after the employees, we have shown you in this model. First is you have to recognize the problems of the employees. Recognizing the problems is to analyze the causes for these problems. Then you have to identify the alternatives. Identification of alternatives would involve a kind of evaluation of alternatives in terms so as to decide upon the course of the action, and course of action basically results into implementation of the chosen optimum solution. You have to monitor the results in order to get the correct action. The review of the correct action is important. The kind of the demotivating conditions which put a negative impact on the profitability of the company results because if these conditions are existing into the company, they would result into lower profits, lower productivity, and the kind of the lower turnover from the employees in order to perform better. This could be the increased absenteeism in the company, the higher incidence of sickness in the company, the complaints about the work, the deteriorating performance, the request for transfers, a desire for job hunting, the increased staff turnover, the non-compliance with the policies, and the increased criticism. So this could be the kind of the basic situation which can exist into the company, and if the internal disturbances are there and the internal conflicts are there, then obviously the sales will be impacted. A considerable impact has to be given in terms to understand the needs of the employees so that the company can build the confidence in terms so that employees are trained to do their jobs in a better way. The feedback of the people will build better policies and the procedures to carry the products to the market. The security in the job would give a pride to the people to work with better relationships. A good working condition gives a meaningful job to the people. Now, basically, it is important that these conditions of demotivating factors are removed by effective leaders. Effective leadership is important because this is the kind of the best practice which can help you in building effective decision making. This helps you to build courageous practices where the employees need to undertake a kind of a training program where they can follow their leaders. Today, an effective leadership means to dominate the art of motivation, to being capable to understand what people want, and to be capable to understand what the talent is and how to upgrade this talent so as to associate with the company's goals and objectives. Basic success of the company comes from effective leader. Effective leader understands the motive of the people. A motive is the impulse that causes the person to act, and this motivation is an internal process where the employees have to relate to the goal. Motivation is like intelligence. It can be observed. It could be genuinely felt. It could be genuinely touched, because you have seen a kind of a picture where the motivated employees generate feelings of happiness and goodness to the company. Now, the basic aspects related to the deficit needs which are reflected in the company's poor performance relate to this model. The deficit needs relate to the physiological needs, the safety needs, the belongingness needs, esteem needs, self-actualization needs, and these needs result into the kind of the hierarchy where you have to build into the kind of the hierarchy. Genuinely, the self-actualization becomes important. We have shown you this picture of a person who is taking a torch and searching for these needs. And wherever the needs match with the market, he will get associated with. So before the company loses an employee, it is important that you match up with each stage of the need and try to build a process of job satisfaction which looks into the kind of the factors related to the quality of the job. Now, the job factors has two impacts. You have the hygiene factors and you have the motivating factors. The hygiene factors relate to work conditions like job security, salary, and the basic working conditions of the market. But these hygiene factors are not motivating factors. See, if bathrooms are available in a company, that doesn't mean people will feel motivated to work. But if bathrooms are not available in the company, people would genuinely leave the job. So these factors are not motivating factors, but they are hygiene factors. So we have shown you these kind of the impacts in terms of the motivation, where the Maslow's impact and the Herzberg's impact is shown. These basic impacts on the salespeople genuinely built the performance for the company. The physiological, safety, social, esteem and self-actualization is the basic impact which carries a kind of motivating impact on the employees. The Herzberg's motivation hygiene theory relates to the hygiene and the maintenance factors related to the kind of the congenial people's working conditions. This is related to the kinds of the good premises, good insurance policies, job security, vacations, holidays, good pay. But the motivating factors relate to the understanding of the job, the challenges, the utilization of one's capability, opportunity to get meaningful jobs, and it is some importance given to the people, and it is assessed to information and improvement in the decision making process. So these are the basic factors explained by the various authors which impact the organizational work process. We have n number of factors putting a kind of a challenge to the company to look after the employees. You have the intrinsic process where you genuinely gain a process of enjoyment when you take up the job. This is the kind of the motivation when people are motivated to genuinely work in a team. The instrumental factors relate to the kind of the incentive which are derived from the company. The concept of self-expectation is derived from one's improved state of personality to the another state. The self-conceptual internal process of upgradation requires a kind of a personal grooming, and the goal internalization is the process where the person tries to internalize the goal of the company with his achievement. Like, you get associated with the commissions and the partnerships and the collaborations. This helps to make the tasks better, and these better tasks help in better performances. The tasks have to be done in such a way that they give pleasure to the people. You have to give enjoyment during activities. When you take people to outdoors, they genuinely feel happy with the association and the networking. You have to get engaged in people with the fun-loving activities, and you have to make the workplace a kind of a beautiful and a creative place. Tasks have to be taken in an easy way. People have to talk about their tasks, they have to communicate about their tasks, and they have to volunteer for whatever has been given to them. When jobs are done in a fun way, it is the kind of the result which you get in tangible rewards. You have to pursue activities which give profits. You have to choose jobs and careers which are based on money and returns. It is both the quality of the life and the quality of the salary, both impacts the jobs. You have to view life as a series of exchange process where genuinely work has to be exchanged in relation to the kind of the pleasure associated with the sense of achievement. Work is not a kind of a stress, but it is genuinely a focus on your personal kind of a crystallization in terms of pleasure. You have to focus on the opinions of others so as to enhance the reputation of the company. The desire to meet their expectations and to build up the interpersonal connections becomes important to genuinely give membership to people in such a way that they get associated with the family environment. We have to seek recognition and praise from the people. Genuinely, a kind of a system of building a feedback. Feedback is a kind of a 360 degree system of building a feedback where the suggestions can come from the employees, and then the company can build up a policy framework to look into those suggestions. The 360 degree impact would be a kind of a non-disclosure of the name of the employee. By this, the employees will be able to communicate openly and would be able to criticize each aspect related to the function of the company. The kind of the achievement-oriented recognition given to the employees would relate to the kind of the ability of the company to speak about its status through the stories and the videos shown, which genuinely speak about the kind of the status achieved in the society, the material gains, the trendy looks, and the kind of the impacts in terms of the job returns become important. The popularity, the fame, the recognition, the travel, the prizes, the rewards, the parties, the fun, everything adds to the special situations and the special occasions which you built for the people so as to make them feel special. You have to meet out with the standards in order to build a self-concept of the person where he tends to be motivated to work for the activities which are associated with the company's goal. Public recognition is important. We have to set out challenges which are genuinely built in the system, and work done with the challenges requires skills. So better talented people, when match up with these kinds of the abilities of the organization, give a kind of a result which is genuinely with the improved performance and improved direction in terms to give better output. You must believe in the cause before you take up any action. You have to engage in the moral and the ethical activities where you have to be concerned not about only the goals and the profits of the company, but a community partnership is important in order to build a kind of a social exchange. A social exchange which is built on the principles of guiding and mentoring people. A social pursuit which is built on the ability to give to the society, to look after the environment, to look after the needy people. These are all things which genuinely motivate people to get associated with the goodness of life. People have to be motivated so that they build a kind of a system of self-esteem. A system of self-esteem is basically a focus on the organization's total process where the conflict is reduced and the cause is explained. So when we stand for a mission of the company, the vision is genuinely articulated in terms to take the concept in such a way that we establish an emotional bonding with the company. The professional and the personal recognition both are important. This kind of recognition is genuinely a kind of a motivation process where we have to identify the process in terms to prioritize their basic relevance to the kind of the crystallization of objectives. Now you have a kind of a goal. Goal theory is basically emphasizing on the need of the employees, that what employees need is the first priority of the companies. In order to increase the performance, you have to set the specific goals for the employees. Difficult goals, when accepted, result in higher performance, and then you get the feedback. The individual commitment is important to crystallize the goal, and this individual commitment builds up the organization commitment, and this organizational commitment gives results to the society. So we have a kind of a management by objective system which genuinely focuses on the objective, that putting the goals at a priority is an important practice. You have to convert the organizational's overall goals into specific objectives, and each specific objectives has to be given to the employees. The four common ingredients of the management by objective program relate to the goal specification, participation in decision making, an explicit time period, and the performance feedback. The failures in the system can result from the unrealistic expectations from the rewarding systems, the lack of commitment of the employees, and the cultural incompatibility. But then you have to look into a kind of basic model which can give you success. The basic model of the success is shown over here in this model, where we have to convert the individual efforts into individual performance. The individual performances have to be converted into organizational rewards, and these organizational rewards give the personal satisfaction. So the personal satisfaction is a kind of a motivation where the organization achieves something, but with the something, the individual is also recognized. Now see this foundation of the total model of success in terms of motivation we have shown you. Here obviously the individual effort and the performance, rewards and goals are shown in the central block. But apart from the individual efforts crystallize when you give them opportunities. These opportunities come from better built jobs. jobs which have a better design and a better kind of a job description. High achievement need of the employees could be crystallized in terms when they have their personal goals crystallized. The performance evaluation criteria helps in the reinforcement to give better rewards, and this is the basic stage where you have the dominant needs. The dominant needs are basically the kinds of the justice put into the organization, because if you have these needs, they are a kind of a system of justification built by the organization, because the organization has to look to the needs of the employees. So this is the total system of interplay of the various factors related to the opportunities, abilities, goals, performance and rewards, giving a recognition to the employees. Now, this is the basic aspects related to the success of the motivation systems which we built into the organizations. But apart from this, we have to build a kind of a committed team, a team genuinely who is able to sacrifice their personal goals for the organizational achievement. So this loyal team could only be built up when you have a system of rewarding their emotional needs of being concerned and caring for them. People are not only bundle of activities or bundle of basic issues related to the performance, but they are the bundles of emotions who have to be tackled in terms of their indispensable need to be left out. They are the particular aspects, they are the components of the company parts which when broken would break the total system. So you have to look into the individual needs and the commitments of the people in such a way that it designs a system of success. Now let's study the basic framework for motivating employees. First essential aspect is to have the clarity for job. You have to recruit only qualified employees who can meet with the job requirements. You have to provide the initial and the ongoing job training. You have to establish the goals and the objectives which could be achieved by the employees. Set the standards for the performance, and basically then it is important that we give the quotas and the specific basically job targets. This is important to motivate the employees. Then you have to provide a kind of a system of motivational rewards and benefits to the people in terms of the packages. You have to demonstrate efficient and effective management systems which can establish a kind of a control system which can look after the indicators of the performance measurements and which could communicate information given to the employees. The open system of communication is important to develop the kind of contacts and the forums where we can exchange the kind of feedback in terms of the meetings. We have to provide regular feedback for whatever has been done in the organization. You have to encourage the staff development programs. You have to promote the use of advanced technology so as to make them updated, and you have to involve the salesperson in the planning process also. The delegation of responsibilities to the people would help them to understand the jobs in a better way. We have to recognize the individual salesperson's personal needs and then give them according to their basic disturbances and the stress which they face in life. We have to manage and motivate their basic needs. Now, these are the basic variables which you have to associate with the job systems where the quality of the employees genuinely impacts the kind of the motivation system existing into the company. But then we have the motivational need audit kind of a performer, which genuinely we rate according to the salesperson's performance. The rating can go from 1 to 6 scale, that is the Likert scale is taken, and then we can take the notes in a defined way, like what the employee is feeling about a particular variable in the company. This is an audit we have shown you. First is the acceptance. Now, what is acceptance? This is the need of acceptance by family, friends, peer groups and the people in the job conditions. Then is affection, a need of basic close relationships where you genuinely have a healthy life built up in the home and in the social network system. Respect, this is the basic need to receive and to show respect for each other. Harmony is the preference of order of relationships in a positive way. Dependence is the need of support and supervision needed by the people. Then is the consolidation. This is the level of satisfaction with the present role, and this is the kind of the status associated with the present responsibility. So we have to basically relate to these aspects where people feel consolidated about their performance in terms what has been given to them. Change, a need to diversify the skills in order to upgrade and to define their skills in a better way. Then is the kind of the activity, a need for a physical and intellectual activity which gears up the mind and the body to rejuvenate, to take up the jobs in a better way. Then is the knowledge, a desire to pursue new knowledge and build better experiences is a passion and a desire for most of the employees. Achievement. Achievement is basically a need for tangible achievements in life in terms of results, status, benefits, recognition and the knowledge. Then is recognition. This is the preference for the public recognition within the peer group and the outside groups also. Then is the responsibility. The need to have the responsibility in terms to handle the situations. Status, the need for feeling of self-worth so as to be associated with the company is important. Then is the power, the feeling of power through the position and through the kind of the status you get into the company. Then is acquisition, the need for having the additional material things beyond the kind of the necessity things. So these are the kind of the basic aspects which require into the kind of the parameters associated with the motivational audit. And this kind of audit profile can help the company to grow the employees in a better way, because here each parameter can be rated on the scale of 1 to 6 for each employee. And then you can see where the employee stands with each need, and according to the each need you can give a kind of a challenge associated with his recognition. The manager's motivational role depends lot on his ability. He has to undergo a process where he becomes a counselor for the employees. Counseling is a kind of a direct motivation given to the employees, where you understand their problems, you understand their performance and try to mentor them in such a way that they take up the higher task. Then recognition, the employees and the managers genuinely have to give recognition in terms that they have to provide a forum where the employees can interact, and then it could be recognized. Like see, you, if you can organize a kind of a award function, this could be a forum where you built a recognition for the employees. Praise and a kind of a sincere recognition given to the employees through the certificates and through the kind of the basic rewards which you give to the employees. Involvement and participation is you help the employees to grow up with their basic personality through the kind of involvement in decision making and in problem solving of the company. Delegation is you delegate important duties to people so they feel trustworthy and they get associated with the organization. Now these are the basic aspects by which you can improve the kind of the motivational level of the people. The manager's leadership role has to basically associate with the kind of the appointment of activities related to the creation of knowledge. You have to give a structure to the organization and you have to build an authority system where most of the needs are looked after in terms to achieve the better group roles and individual roles. A combination of both, that is the group and the individual needs, would build up a kind of a system of healthy, sustainable, trustworthy relationships where the involvement, where the participation, where the recognition and a kind of a emotional bonding would promote a kind of a clarity in terms of the performance for the results. Motivation is important in terms of decision making also. This decision making is the kind of the impact on the quality of the results given to the company. Higher is the involvement in decision making, higher is the kind of the result for meeting out the kind of the insecurities with the employees, because here everything becomes open. A good decision is a kind of an impact of various people's thoughts and process put together, and decision is also a concept of emotional bonding of people together. So this is all about motivation. I hope the students must have understood the impact of motivation on the organizational health and how the employees have to undergo a process of building a kind of a system where fair work conditions give fair rewards. Individual commitments are important. These individual commitments built up the organizational commitment, and these organizational commitment built up the society, and this society helps the civilizations to grow in a better way. Thank you, students.